Hey everybody, Emma here. This is our 7th dog vlog now, and I'm really appreciating all your contributions, including your comments, your pictures that you've been sending in whenever I've done a vlog, and also your questions. So it's really, really great to have those, and bear in mind that I do really appreciate feedback. So when you're watching this, maybe leave a comment underneath. Thank you. Okay, so we're going to talk about the competition that I spoke about last week, and that was Guess the Breed competition. So we showed you three pictures of three different types of puppies, and you had to say what their breed was. Okay, so number one puppy was a beagle, number two puppy was a Bichon Frise, and number three were border terriers puppies, and they were so cute. So congratulations to Amy Never 345, who sent us an email with all those correct answers. So she did really well, and she won $50 worth of music, all for just sending in that email. So it's worth doing, guys. So congratulations, Amy, and thanks for taking part, everybody else. Now, I mentioned this week on my Facebook that there was a program on ITV in the UK called Secret Lives of Dogs, and it was incredible. And I think you guys should all watch it, especially if you love dogs, which I assume everybody does. So definitely watch it, definitely try and catch up on it. If you're outside of the UK, maybe try and watch it on YouTube. Because it was definitely worth it. There were dogs detecting cancer in their owners. There were dogs curing people of diseases. There was a disease where a man could no longer feel emotion, and it was a dog that actually got him out of that and connected him back with his family and friends. So it was really heartwarming. It was really, really lovely. And also it showed you how guide dogs are trained. So dogs that lead the blind. And that was amazing, because they're brought trained from puppies. And also, coming from that, it showed you that your dog is either left or right pawed or handed. I'm not sure what you say, but a way to tell which paw is your dog's most dominant one is next time they're sat down and they go to stand up, you have to see which paw they lift first. And apparently, those guide dogs who were being trained, the ones with the who were right pawed, were more successful and more likely to get through. So there you go. Right, question time now. And basically our first question is from, and our only question this vlog, is from TomR528, and he asks us on YouTube, my Labrador Max is very strong. Any tips on how I can keep him at my side or behind me? If I hold him on a short leash, he'll run through my legs. Okay, difficult one, because I have done a question about leash walking before, but this is a bit different because he specifically goes through the legs and he's very strong. So basically what, by the way, going through the legs is something that puppies do when to their mothers, so that's a sign that they are actually being very friendly and trust you. But obviously it's a bit annoying when you're on a walk. Okay, so tip number one, you must act as a pack leader. Body language is essential. You must hold your head high and your shoulders back when you're walking, and you must be confident, be positive. You never know how much that will help, but honestly that is something that is really, really important. In terms of when you put your collar on the dog, make sure the dog comes to you. You should not go to the dog. You call the dog, you put the collar on. Make sure you put the collar at the top of the neck, not the bottom of the neck, because the bottom of the neck is where dogs have all their pulling power. So this is where huskies pull in snow. And so therefore, if it's at the bottom of the neck, the dog is gonna pull and it's gonna have a lot of power. So at the top of the neck is the best place to put a collar, because that's just gonna, you know, act as a collar, not as a rein, shall we say. And it's excellent, as Tom has already said, that he's walking with a short leash. You should use a short leash. However, you should make sure that the short leash is held loosely, so there's slack in it. Now, flexi leads, so you know, the long leads that come back and stretch out, really aren't very good in terms of communication. It's really difficult for the owners to communicate with their dog, and also it means they're going to lose control over the dog. So remember, short leash, everybody, but it must be loose. Now, when your Labrador goes between your legs or starts to go in front of you or does something you don't like, you should give a short, quick tug on the leash. And when you do give the short, quick tug, pull it up and up and out. So you need to pull the leash, and tug it up and out, and then put your dog exactly where you want him, and then carry on. Now, this is going to take a lot of repetition before your dog finally comes to terms with it, but this is honestly the best method that I've seen. Is you just have to do a quick tug, up and out, and then bring him back to your side and then carry on the walk. But that's honestly, you're going to have to repeat and repeat and repeat that for that to be successful. So good luck, Tom. Any more advice I can think of, I will make sure to give you guys, because honestly, walking the dog is all about patience and repetition. You just have to keep doing it every single day. It's really, really important. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about is feedback. So you guys are always really good at leaving comments, but we've uploaded almost 30 videos now and we've had such a great response from everybody. But what we want to know is to make sure that we're enhancing the experience for your dogs as much as possible, is we want to know what works best for you guys. So, for example, do your dogs relax better or sleep better when there's piano music? Do your dogs like nature sounds? Do they prefer like lots of different combinations of instrument, or do they dislike the sound sweep sound? So we need to know basically everything that you guys think and what your dogs prefer, what works best, what doesn't work. If there's any videos that haven't worked on your dog, then please let us know and we'll try and collate these opinions and ideas and basically figure out what the best recipe for good music for your dog is. Okay, so please leave your comments below. You can also write to us on Facebook or on Twitter with your feedback, and we would really, really, really appreciate that. So please, everybody, get involved. Let us know what works, what doesn't, what makes your dog most happy. Okay, that's all for this week, guys. Remember, if you've got any questions, please send them in to me. I'm happy to answer them. I will do my best to get all of them in the next dog vlog. But for now, that's it, and I'll speak to you guys soon. Bye-bye.